When I was in Washington talking to Pastor Mark Blitz, he asked me if I'd ever considered the study of the lunar eclipse with regard to a prophetic signal. I said, no. He said, you should. So I came home, and thinking about what the pastor had said, I sat down at my computer and began to work. I knew that our Bible, this one, was written on the lunar calendar. Our calendar, the Western civilization calendar, is the Gregorian calendar from Pope Gregory of Rome. That means it's pagan in origin. It's not God's calendar. Our calendar and the calendar of this book do not match. Sun God is for Sunday. Moon God is for Monday. That's a sermon for another time. Believe me, much of what Christianity salutes is pagan to its roots.
The Sabbath is not on Saturday or on Sunday. The Sabbath was never on Saturday, or was it on Sunday? The Sabbath is regulated by the moon, okay? When our Creator created this world, He created the moon for us to use the moon as our calendar. So if you read Genesis chapter 1 verse 14, Psalm 104 verse 19, Ezekiel chapter 46 verse 1 to 3, even in Isaiah chapter 6, chapter 66, verse 22 and verse 23, you will see that our Heavenly Father says that in the future, that everyone must keep the Sabbath day and they must keep the new moon day. He said that from one new moon to another and from one Sabbath to another, all flesh will come and worship Him. So, but if you look at the calendar we're using today, there is no new moon day. We're commanded in Ezekiel chapter 46, verse 1 to 3, that the Sabbath the temple should be open on the Sabbath day and on the new moon day, and that we must worship on the Sabbath day and on the new moon day. But today, we're no longer worshiping on a new moon day because we are using a man-made calendar. The calendar we're using today is a man-made calendar. It was made in AD 1582 AD. About 400 and something years ago, it was made by a Roman Catholic Pope by the name of Pope Gregory. The man that made the calendar we're using today is Pope Gregory in AD 1582 AD. So before then, the whole world was using the moon as their calendar. If you really study about calendar, you will see that the moon used to regulate the month. So when our Heavenly Father told us to keep the Sabbath on the seventh day, He wasn't talking about 7 day of a man-made calendar. If you read in 1 Samuel chapter 20, you will see that the Israelites was using the moon as their calendar. I highly recommend you read the whole chapter. 1 Samuel chapter 20, you read the whole chapter, you will see that the ancient Israelites, they were using the moon as their calendar. If you read in Colossians chapter 2, from verse 1 to verse 16, you will see that the early followers of Christ was also using the moon as their calendar. So if you read in verse 8, Colossians chapter 2, verse 8, all the way down to verse 16, you will see that Paul was encouraging the early followers of Christ. He was encouraging them not to let anybody condemn them or judge them by them keeping the new moon day or the Sabbath day or the feast day. Today, people are using that chapter or that verse, Colossians 2:16. People are using it to say, hey, look, it says that don't let anybody judge you. Yes, it's saying don't let anybody judge you for keeping those days, for keeping the Sabbath day, for keeping the new moon day, and all the other feasts. So you have to read from verse 1, Colossians chapter 2. Colossians chapter 2 from verse 1 to verse 16. But pay attention to verse 8, because verse 8 makes it very clear that he was warning them not to let anybody condemn them for keeping those days, like the new moon day. Today, we are no longer keeping a new moon day because we're using a man-made calendar. But our Creator created the moon for us to use the moon as our calendar. Now, this is what His calendar looked like. This is what it looks like. This is the phases of the moon, okay? According to the way the moon regulates the month, there are 29 days in our Creator's calendar. His days doesn't exceed 30 days. It doesn't go to, we don't have 31st day of the month. Okay, that's what you have in a man-made calendar. So there are 29 days in our Creator's calendar. And there are four Sabbaths in a month. Okay, when he says for us to keep the Sabbath, there are four Sabbaths in his month. And there are 29 days in his month. From the time the moon comes out till the time the moon is gone, it takes 29 days. So when it comes out and it starts increasing, and the time that it's, you know, it disappears, it takes 29 days. So at the beginning of the month, the moon is usually dark at the beginning of the month. You will have a dark moon like what you see in this picture. That's the first day of the month. That is the new moon day. That's the day that we're commanded, according to Ezekiel chapter 46, verse 1 to 3, we're commanded to worship on a new moon day. The moon is usually dark. And you can see more about this in 1 Samuel chapter 20. If you read 1 Samuel chapter 20, it clearly shows that the ancient Israelites, they were using the moon as their calendar. So at the beginning of the month, the moon is usually dark. Very dark. You will not be able to see it. That day is a worship day at the beginning of the month. It's a new moon day that he said that we must worship on that day. So according to Ezekiel 46 verse 1 to 3. So at the beginning of the month, the moon is dark. Then 7 days after that, the moon will be 50% full. 7 days after the new moon day, the moon is 50% full. That's a Sabbath day. Okay, whenever you see the moon 50% full, it means that the next day is the Sabbath day. Then 7 days after that, the moon is 100% full. Okay, when you see a full moon, when the moon is 100% full, it's full, it means that night, it means that the next day is the Sabbath day. Then 7 days after that, the moon will be 50% full. Again, at this point, it's beginning to decline. It's 50% full again. Then that's a Sabbath day, the third Sabbath of the month. Then 7 days after that, the fourth Sabbath of the month, the moon will be very, very tiny. Sometimes you may not even be able to see it on the last Sabbath of the month. Then the very next day is a new moon day again. So this happens four times in a month. You have four Sabbaths in a month. Four Sabbaths in a month. There are 29 days. You have 29 days in a month, okay, and four Sabbaths in a month, and the beginning of the month is a new moon day. The beginning of the first day, the very first day of the month is a new moon day, and on a new moon day, the moon is usually dark. It's very dark. So then, after that new moon day, the moon will begin to increase, and for 29 days, it will begin to increase, and then so that's. This is what the calendar looks like. This is how our Creator's calendar is regulated. And he made this from the beginning because he couldn't tell us to work for 6 days and keep the Sabbath day holy without telling us when. And the calendar we're using today was made about 400 and something years ago. So before then, how did people keep the Sabbath? They were using the moon, if you study these things out yourself. So this is what our Creator's calendar looks like. Why does this even matter? Why does it matter? It matters because the Sabbath is something that our Heavenly Father gave to everybody. It's not just for the children of Israel. Everybody must keep the Sabbath, whether you are an Israelite or not. If you look in Numbers chapter 15, verse 15 and verse 16, Numbers chapter 15, verse 15 and verse 16, you will see that our Heavenly Father says that all the laws and the commandments you read in this book, it applies to everybody. It applies to everybody, whether you are an Israelite or not. You must keep all the laws and the commandments in this book. So, and part of those commandments is the Sabbath day. And he said in Isaiah chapter 56 that those he will bring to his mountain, basically talking about Jerusalem, those he will bring to his mountain when Christ comes back are those that kept the Sabbath. Whether you are a Gentile or you are an Israelite, you must keep the Sabbath. And Christ makes it very clear in Matthew chapter 5, verse 17 to verse 19. Matthew chapter 5, verse 17 to verse 19, Christ makes it very clear that we must keep every single law, every single law that was given to us by Moses, that we must keep it. In Matthew chapter 23, verse 1 to 3, Christ commanded the multitude that was listening to him and his apostle. He commanded them to keep every single law and the commandment found in the Old Testament. Okay, and I can go on and on and on and on. In 1 John chapter 2, verse 3 to verse 6, it says, "By this we know that we know him, if we keep his commandment." If somebody claims to know him but doesn't keep his commandment, that person is a liar, and there's no truth in that person. Okay, so we must keep every single law and the commandment that was given to us, including the Sabbath day. And the Sabbath is not on Saturday, it's not on Sunday. The Sabbath is regulated by the moon. And this picture right here is what the Sabbath looks like. This is what this is what it looks like. So when you see a dark moon, when the moon is 100% dark, that's a new moon day. On a new moon day, usually you don't see a moon. And sometimes there are two days new moon. Sometimes there are 1 day new moon. Okay? It depends. So you have 1 day new moon, or you have a 2 day new moon. This is the period of time it takes the moon to regenerate and come back out again, because he made the moon for us to use it as our calendar. So when you have a 1 day new moon, the moon will be dark just for 1 day. And that day, that's the beginning of the month. That day is a worship day. The new moon day is a worship day. And then after that, the moon will begin to increase. After that, the very next day is the first work day of the month. There are three types of days. You have the Sabbath day, you have the new moon day, and you have the work day. Okay? So on the new moon day is a worship day. The Sabbath day is a worship day. A work day is a day that you go and work, you know, make your living and do whatever you want to do, as long as it's according to the law. You do whatever you want according to the law. And then on the Sabbath day, you rest. So if you have any question, please feel free to comment below the video or send me a message. I will definitely respond to your comment or to your message if you have any question. We also have other videos in this channel that may be of interest to you. We have videos about tassel or about other topics, about food and about shaving your beard, things like that. So, but I highly recommend that you study these things out yourself. Keep in mind that he made the moon for us to use it as our calendar. The early followers of Christ was also using the moon as their calendar when they keep the Sabbath. In 1 Samuel chapter 1 verse 1 Samuel chapter 20, you will see that the Israelites was also using the moon as their calendar. So I highly recommend that you continue to look into this, look into history books. You will see that before this man-made calendar we're using today was made, the whole world was using the moon as their calendar. So thank you so much for watching. And remember, in Revelation chapter 22 verse 14, Christ makes it very clear that those who will be allowed into the kingdom of heaven are those that kept the commandments of our Heavenly Father. That is the reason why this is very important. Those who will be saved are those who keep the laws and the commandment. So I really, really appreciate you spending your time to watch this video, and I'm kind of hoping that this, you know, opens up this information in your mind for you to take it up, pick it up from here, and study it out yourself. I know this may not be this may not be enough to give you all the information you need about the lunar calendar, but at least I'm hoping that this will be a kickoff point for you to start and study this out for yourself more. And I want to thank you for watching this video. And until next time, remain blessed.